Meanwhile, a plane of the Russian Ministry for Emergency Situations has airlifted to Moscow 18 seriously ill children from Donbas, the ministry's press service stated. The patients, the youngest of whom aged less than 1 year old, have different diagnoses, but all of them need highly qualified aid that cannot be offered at local clinics in the war-torn region. A new humanitarian aid convoy is ready to head for Ukraine's Donbas on Thursday, sources from the Russian Ministry for Emergency Situations National Crisis Management Center told TASS on Wednesday. The 26th humanitarian convoy of more than 100 vehicles will carry to the troubled Donetsk and Lugansk region more than 1,100 tons of cargo, mainly foodstuffs, including tinned fish and milk, flour, rice and cereals, as well as essentials, construction materials and textbooks. According to the sources, the truck convoy of the Emergencies Ministry has started from the Rostov region early in the morning. From August 2014, Russian humanitarian convoys have delivered to Donbas about 33,000 tons of aid. Serious concerns have been raised by experts and environmentalists over the shocking way spent nuclear fuel is being stored at Zaporizhzhia nuclear power plant, Europe's largest, just 200 kilometers away from the front line in Donbas. More than 3,000 spent nuclear fuel rods are being stored in the open air in metal casks close to the perimeter fence at the Zaporizhzhia nuclear power plant in conditions that have shocked environmentalists, The Guardian reports. Nuclear experts say the waste should have another secondary containment structure, such as building with a roof. In turn, in Germany, interim storage operators have been ordered by the court to tear-proof their casks with roofs and reinforced walls. Despite international agreements that regulate activities in the field of biological research, US has established chemical weapons labs in Ukraine. According to reports, during last year, new biolaboratories were opened in Vinnytsia, Chernobyl, Uzhgorod, Kyiv, Lviv and Dnipropetrovsk. Remember, immediately after the victory of the first color revolution, a package deal was